Hi there, welcome back to the Cosmic Classroom. Now it's time to talk about the life of high mass stars. And I know you want to know about them because they end as black holes, and that's something you're really curious about. I know that. So let's get to it. So high mass stars start their life just like low mass stars. They go through the same process of being a main sequence star, fusing hydrogen into helium in its core, and then starting to fuse helium in the core, and then when it gets to carbon, actually the star has enough mass that indeed it does get hot enough in that core for it to fuse carbon into heavier elements, and heavier and heavier and heavier. So the beginning, I don't need to repeat, the beginning, go back to life of low mass stars. But if the star has enough mass, has more than 8 times the mass of the Sun, it will be able to fuse heavier and heavier elements all the way to iron. So let's see here. We have, can we take, yeah, thank you. So high mass stars, so same stages, and high mass stars continue this process as you can see here. Until eventually what we have is a star that looks more like an onion than a star. It has shells and shells and shells fusing different things, right? So the very core of this, eventually at the very core of this star, what you have is iron. Iron won't be able to fuse into anything, right? And around it, you have silicon. And around that, you have magnesium. And around that, you have neon and oxygen and carbon and helium and hydrogen. So you have a lot of fusion happening. You can only imagine that if you're fusing all of those elements at the same time, this star is huge, right? It's generating a large amount of energy. So this star becomes a supergiant, all right? But as the low mass stars, eventually they run out of fuel because they can't fuse iron and everything else becomes too cold, right? And it can't be fused. So what's going to happen to it? It's interesting to notice that stars that are very massive, they actually go through all of these processes much faster than stars that are low mass like our Sun. Think about it like someone that's biking and saving its energy and goes slowly and keeps going and going and going and going and never has to refuel. And then think about the Hummer that you need to keep refueling. So it has a lot of fuel, but it runs out of it, right? When a small star just uses it so slowly that it lasts for a very long time. So high mass stars actually live much less, die much younger than a lower mass star. So you have this multiple shell burning. You probably remember this plot from before, showing that you can only get energy out of the fusion of elements lighter than iron. When you get to iron, what happens is, first of all, the iron will build in the core until the degeneracy pressure of this iron cannot hold it anymore, cannot hold all this gravity. Imagine, it's a huge force, right? There's this huge star all around this nucleus and this core of iron that's becoming smaller and smaller and denser and denser. Eventually, not even the degeneracy pressure is able to stop the atoms to come and combine with each other. So what happens is that at this pressure, a proton combines with an electron and forms a neutron. You lose any information about what kind of elements were there before. You don't know that it was, if it was iron or what was it, because as you see here, protons will combine with an electron and form a neutron. Right? So you have a huge ball of neutron. That's what you have. You have a huge ball of neutron. When this huge ball of neutron collapses, it may do one of two things. It will explode in a supernova, and then it may do one of two things. It may either keep this neutron star, this core that's made only of neutrons. To give you an idea of how dense this is, And I'll talk more about neutron stars in some other time because they're fascinating. But just to give you a glimpse, a neutron star has a density such that if you just get the volume of your thumb, imagine fitting every person in the surface of the Earth and squeezing them here, at the surface of my thumb. Not at the surface, just squeeze it in the volume of my thumb. Everybody, the 6 billion people at the surface of the Earth. That's how dense it is in a neutron star. It's mind-boggling, isn't it? That's what it is. And if the explosion, and depending on the mass, if the explosion is big enough, you end up with a black hole. So when a supernova explodes, you even have at the end a black hole or a neutron star. Two fascinating objects that I love to talk to you about. And it will come. You just wait because it will come. All right? So that's how high mass stars die, with a big supernova explosion. I hope that helped, and I'll see you next time.